3 years ago now, I did a review of this Poundland remote, and I thoroughly recommend it. It's very, very good. Bit of a tip, if you ever need to change the batteries on it, whatever code you need to put in to make your TV or whatever work, write it on the back, cover it with sellotape, and then when you change the batteries, you don't have to go looking for the code again. Oh yeah, nice tip. I got this one. It cost 100% more than the Poundland one. Got this one from Poundstretcher. And it's a Hudson brand. Hudson, as I'd say. It doesn't include batteries, neither did the Poundland one. So I've got some Hyundai batteries, also from Poundstretcher. Well, it's really bargain buys, but it's the same company, same price labels. You may think I've just pronounced that wrong. Hyundai, I did. It's Hyundai. There's an H in Hyundai. That's just to wind everyone up, because it's got about five different pronunciations, hasn't it? Some people say Hyundai, some people say Hyundai. Hyundai, I don't particularly like, because it sounds like someone yawning. It's like Hyundai. There's a lot of opening this one, I think, because it's quite slack, the packaging. And there we go, this is what we get when you pay 100% more. Well, not 100% more. What is it, 99% more? Because it was £1.99 instead of a pound. Have a good smell for YouTube. Has it got that lovely plastic smell? Let's have a smell. Oh, it does. I love the smell of brand new plastic. Let's get a couple of batteries in here. There is a book. Yes, there's a book with codes on it, just like the Poundland one. Let's see. Because I've not got this for the telly, I've got it for the amplifier. And I'm hoping it works for this. This doesn't look as very comprehensive, the list. But I'm hoping, since it's still four numbers, I can use the same code for this remote as I did for this one. Let's get some batteries in. Well, the batteries fit in better. They're more robust. Ooh, there was a flashy light straight away there. Just to show that it was working. I'm gonna guess how to do this. What's the code that I need again? 2030 in it? Oh no, 3060. I'm gonna weld down AUX and see if this is the way you do it. So I'm holding down AUX. This is the way you do it. I'm holding down AUX. Not ask. no, it's not. Oh. Right, it looks as if I'm going to have to read the instructions. Instructions easy enough. It's the same as this one. You've just got to hold down the set button and then what you want to control. So I'm going to hold down the set button. And then we've got to hold down the set button, it says. I'm doing that. I'm holding it. And then maybe at the same time press what I want to press. I'm going to press AUX. Then it says release. Oh, and the light does stay on. Then I'm going to put on the same code, which is 3060. 3060. Stayed in setup mode. That means it's not going to work. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's not going to work, this one. It does, to be fair, say it's only going to work with TV. What does it say on the instruction book? Operates TV, VCR, gosh, does anyone still have a VCR? CD, DVD, Hi-Fi, and satellite. No Blu-ray. Would it do Blu-ray? We don't know. Let's see if Onkyo's on here. Let's see if we can get one of the other codes. Maybe it's not the same code. I just need to find Onkyo again. I'll be right back. Onkyo's got much more numbers on it. Many more numbers on it than what the Poundland one did. So I'm hoping one of these works. That's quite good. I will try the Hi-Fi ones first, but neither of these numbers are the same as the Poundland one. If you watch the Poundland remote control video, maybe the codes on this sheet will work. Who knows? Maybe this remote will work better for you than this one, if this doesn't work for you at all. Ooh, the mysteries. I'll try some codes now. 0536. Let's see if it turns it on. Ooh, let's see. It did. It did turn it on. Is the volume going to be in the right place? Oh, this is a very good start. First time, and it works first time. But it still could be too good to be true. Let it just continue to turn on. And let's see if the volume buttons are in the right place and everything. Because all we need is the volume for this, really. Volume up. It does! First time, and it worked first time. That is so much better because it feels a bit more substantial than the Poundland one. It feels 100% better, actually. The plastic isn't so clicky. The batteries on the Poundland one can be a bit fragile. If you drop it on the floor, it tends to forget. Like the other one, I'm going to write the code on the back and put a piece of sellotape over it. Should I need to change the batteries in this, I won't need to go remembering what code I used. That is really good. That is really good. So if the Poundland one didn't work for you, maybe the Poundstretcher one will. Let's have a look at the brand again, so we don't forget what it was. Where was it? Here it is. So it was the Hudson Electronics Universal TV Remote. Works with most TV brands. Well, even amplifiers as well, because that wasn't even mentioned on here. Look at the state of that red nail varnish she's got. Quite a weird hand as well, doesn't it? So can I copy that? Can I copy that? I should maybe get some red. What is she pressing there? She's pressing the 5, isn't she? There we are. I'll press the 5 as well. Is that a good match? Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scratch Bellamy. Let me know in the comment section down below, because isn't it annoying when your original remote breaks? I've written on 0536 and I put a bit of sellotape over it. Like I said, that's what the best thing is to do. Any questions? Let me know in the comment section down below. I get many people asking for codes. Well, here's the code sheet.